These are the focus tonight. Sarawak Government establishes Center of Excellence for Clean Energy. Sarawak Government secures study grant from South Korea. APGH 2024 puts Sarawak at forefront of green energy industry. South Korean Ambassador pays courtesy call on Sarawak Premier. Sarawak Governor receives courtesy call from YPBN. Good evening. The Sarawak Government announced the establishment of a Centre of Excellence for Clean Energy in line with its commitment towards innovation and progress in the clean energy sector. According to Sarawak Premier Datuk Patidi Tan Sri Dr. Abang Abdul Rahman Zuhari Tun Dato' Abang Openg, the Centre of Excellence will be a hub for innovation, research and development. He said it will bring together scientists, engineers, policy makers and industry leaders to pioneer cutting-edge technologies that harness renewable resources.
It will drive advancement in clean energy domains such as hydrogen, hydroelectric, solar energy, biomass, and other emerging forms. Our focus will be on sustainable energy solutions that address present needs while safeguarding the well-being of future generations.
He said this in his keynote address in conjunction with the opening ceremony of the Asia-Pacific Green Hydrogen Conference and Exhibition, APGH 2024, at the Borneo Convention Centre, Kuching, BCCK, on Monday. In this regard, Datuk Patinggi Abang Zuhari explained that the Centre of Excellence is a policy established for the Sarawak Government to collaborate with the private sector and strategic partners. He added that it was also established to get the right input in the implementation of policies and at the same time consolidate the output of researchers at the centre to ensure progress. In another development, Datuk Patinggi Abang Zuhari said the Sarawak Government through the Ministry of Energy and Environmental Sustainability has secured a prestigious study grant from the South Korean government through its Ministry of Economy and Finance. He said this grant is to advance Sarawak in the hydrogen economy by partnering with South Korea to explore innovative strategies for hydrogen production and utilization.
This grant will enable us to embark on the groundbreaking study to develop the Sarawak Hydrogen Roadmap, a comprehensive blueprint for harnessing the immense potential of hydrogen energy in our state.
The Sarawak Premier added that the Sarawak Hydrogen Roadmap will guide the government's efforts covering technological advancements, infrastructure development and regulatory frameworks. Meanwhile, when speaking in a press conference after the opening ceremony of APGH 2024, Datuk Patinggi Abang Zuhari said the handover of this grant is also one of the collaborative plans with the South Korean government in decarbonizing their country.
So we can work together with the Korean. Now, that's why we want to produce that hydrogen here. And that hydrogen will be brought to Korea. Mm. Actually, they are now building a terminal in their power plant. The moment the terminal is producing 6 gigawatt using coal. So they are changing the coal to biomass and also through what called hydrogen. So they're building terminal to receiving in Korea. So they are working together with Sarawak.
Therefore, the Sarawak Premier stressed that APGH 2024 is the best platform in putting Sarawak at the forefront of the green energy industry. According to him, it is also a platform for companies and stakeholders to get involved in the green energy industry with the Sarawak government.
We are sharing our success in our success in reducing the power needed from 60 kilowatt hour to 38. I was in Europe. They told me they cannot be done. I was in Europe. They said, no, I don't think you can do that. But we proved it can be done.
During the opening ceremony of APGH 2024, the Sarawak Premier also witnessed the exchange of 8 documents and memoranda between several stakeholders. Earlier on Monday morning, Datuk Patidei Abang Zuhari received a courtesy visit from the Ambassador of the Republic of Korea to Malaysia, Yeo Song-bae, at BCCK. When met by reporters after the courtesy call, Yeo Song-bae said that cooperation between South Korea and Sarawak needs to be enhanced through renewable energy.
I talked with the Premier, mainly focusing on green hydrogen project. We call it Hibiscus, and also CCU, carbon capture and utilization project.
He added that the South Korean government is committed to carry out projects in collaboration with the Sarawak government. The Governor of Sarawak, Tun Perhin Sri Dr. Wan Junaidi, Tuanku Jaafar, received a courtesy call from the National Book Development Foundation, YPBN, at the Astana Negeri Sarawak on Monday. The delegation was led by Chairman of the Managing Board of YPBN, Tan Sri Professor Datuk Wira Dr. Abdul Latif Abu Bakar. During the meeting, he praised the Sarawak Governor as a leader and statesman full of knowledge who published many works.
Saya bincang dengan Universiti Sarawak, Universiti Sarawak, untuk membuat kajian toko ini. Toko ini bukan saja peringkat Sarawak tau, antarabangsa. Kalau kita tengok parti, kita rasa gembira sebab sebagai ilmuwan, dengan banyak buku karya dia, dan karyanya bukan secara imajinasi, realiti. Beliau sebagai pakar undang-undang, pegawai tadbir, dan sebagai ahli politik, kalau dapat diceritakan sebagai dalam sebuah buku yang menarik, ini adalah satu contoh tauladan yang baik untuk generasi rakyat Malaysia.
He said this when met by reporters after the courtesy call. Meanwhile, Tan Sri Dr. Abdul Latif informed that among the things that were also discussed during the courtesy visit was the National Book Award Program, which will be held on 12 September, whereby he invited the Sarawak Governor to attend the event. And that's the English edition with me, Didina Shafiqah. More news can be found in our official portal, upas.sarawak.gov.my, and social media platforms, including Facebook and YouTube. Only 68 days remain until the commencement of the 21st Malaysia Games Sukma Sarawak 2024. We would like to take this moment to invite all Sarawakians to celebrate and enliven this prestigious sporting event later in August. Hashtag Saluran Informasi Rakyat. Have a good night.